Good morning, dear children. Welcome to Moral Science class. You must take personal responsibility. You cannot change the circumstances, the seasons, or the wind, but you can change yourself. Today, you are going to study the sixth chapter, The Chart. Children, today we are going to study a story based on self-reliance. Do you know, children, what is self-reliance? Self-reliance means self-independent.
Bina was very happy. Their teacher had asked them to make a chart on rainforest. Do you know, children, what is rainforest? It is an area of tall, mostly evergreen trees and high amount of rainfall. Bina's mother was very good at drawing and she knew how to cut up bits of colored paper and stick them on the chart paper to make the most beautiful shapes. When Bina was in class 4, her mother had helped her to make beautiful charts on birds. In the evening, when she reached home after the school, she called her mom. Mom, mom, our teacher asked us to volunteer to make charts on the rainforest of India. I volunteered. I am going to make the most beautiful chart. The mother was very excited. The mother asked, are you? I am glad you volunteered. You better start planning the chart. Do you know, children, why Bina accepted to become the volunteer? Because she thought that her mother would make the chart for her. Children, is it right to make others complete your work? No, isn't it? Bina also told her father about the chart. Her father said, that should be fun. He asked his wife, so Anita, what are you planning to make the trees out of? But she replied, I am not studying in Bina's school. Ask Bina how she is planning to make the trees. What do you mean? Bina shouted. Mom, you made the most beautiful peacock and quails when I was in class 4 for my school project. Her mother replied, I only helped you. I cut the pieces and told you where to stick them. And I even made you cut the pieces of paper after I had shown you how to do it, isn't it? Don't you remember it, Bina? And don't forget, you were in class 4 then and now you are in class 7. You will have to make the chart yourself. Do you know, children, what happened? Bina was very angry. She shouted and screamed and stamped her feet. But her mother spoke to her sternly. You will have to make the chart yourself. You better start planning it, she said. But I don't know, Bina complained. You volunteered in the class, so you will have to make the chart, her mother said. All right then, burst out Bina. I shall tell my teacher that I can't make the chart. And the next day, she told her friends, I am not going to make the chart. I shall tell the teacher today. This was heard by Shraddha. She asked her, Why are you not going to make the chart? Suddenly, Bina realized that she didn't want to tell Shraddha that she wasn't making the chart because her mother is not helping her. She said, No, I have too much work. Shraddha advised that Mrs. Gomes will get angry if you refuse to make the chart. In the end, Bina said nothing to Mrs. Gomes. She had 10 days left to submit the chart. She decided to make the chart. Every evening after finishing her homework, Bina set out to do the work. It was not an easy job. After a long-lasting effort, she finished the chart. But it was too shabby. She used too much gum to stick the bits of paper. The leaves were sticking together in clumps. She did not give up. She took another chart paper and began all over again. Her mother was watching her. When she saw that Bina was being more careful, she smiled to herself. Bina measured the distance from the top and put the light dots on the paper. Now draw the line along the dots, she advised. Bina listened to her mother carefully and did what her mother had suggested. This time she wrote the caption, The Rainforest of India, in red. She worked with concentration and everything came out well. She moaned and groaned, yet when it was over, it was a real treat to look at. It was neat and perfect. The lines were straight. The lettering of the words was neat. The trees looked healthy and green. In fact, the chart was beautiful. The next day, she took the chart to school. "That's super," her friend said. Bina held the chart up high so that everyone could see clearly. Bina became more confident now. She is now ready to take new challenges. By doing her work herself, Bina learned to be careful, to depend on herself, and to take responsibility for her own actions. Children, this is what is called self-reliance. Self-reliance is equal to self-independence.
A boy was studying in Harishchandra High School, Kashi. His hometown was 8 miles away from Kashi. He used to walk all the way to school. On the way, he was required to cross the river Ganga. During that period, the boatman had to be paid 2 paisa to cross the river by boat. That means he had to pay 2 rupees per month for crossing the river both ways. In those days, an amount of 2 rupees was quite substantial. The boy learned to swim instead of asking money from his parents, thinking that it might cause a burden on them. He made it a habit to swim the river to reach the school, no matter what the season, whether summer, monsoon or winter. Once, he entered the water of River Ganga in the morning of a very cold winter day. When he was in midstream, some people traveling in a boat noticed him, and they thought that the small boy was drowning. Therefore, they brought the boat near him, caught his hands, and pulled him into the boat. There was no trace of fear or anxiety on the face of that boy. All the people in the boat were amazed at this extraordinary courage. Those people asked, "You would have drowned now. It is not advisable to show such courage." The boy replied, "Courage is a virtue. One has to be courageous. Challenges in life are inevitable. And in order to face and counter them, having courage is a must. If I do not become courageous from this moment, how will I accomplish difficult tasks in my life?" "Why did you choose to swim at this hour? You should have come in the afternoon." "I have not entered the river to have a swim, but to go to school." "Then you should go by boat." 4 paisa are required to go by boat every day. I do not wish to cause burden on my poor parents. I want to be self-reliant. I do not wish to cause them anxiety by increasing their expenses for my sake. It would be hard for them to run the household." People looked at him with great admiration. Later, the same boy became the Prime Minister of Bharat. That young courageous boy was Lal Bahadur Shastri. Despite being on such a high position, he possessed virtues like truthfulness, purity, honesty, courage, simplicity and patriotism. He was an embodiment of good conduct. Such outstanding persons leave a long-lasting impression on the minds of common people.
So children, believe that you can do what you have set out to do. Never depend upon others to do your work for you. If you make a commitment, honor it. Take responsibility for your own actions.
Self-reliance brings you self-respect. Children, you have to become self-reliant. You have to become self-confident. This will bring smile on your parents' face.
Thank you, children.